All right, it's 4:02. Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, Team Qualimed and Qualimed friends, no, and partners. If you're joining us this afternoon, magandang hapon po. Welcome to our session 5, our last session for our QH and our Qualimed Health Network OSH webinar series. Yes, this is correct. This is our 5th session already in the last, well, more than 8 weeks naman. In the last 8 weeks, we've had 4 sessions already. First, we had our NTB in the workplace. And then the following week, we had drug and alcohol free workplace. And then ending the stigma, living and working with HIV. And only last week, we had managing Hepa B in the workplace. This afternoon, we are very lucky to have esteemed doctors from our network who will help us in this afternoon discussion. Ang ating topic for this afternoon, ang ating title pala is Hagardo Versosa, Battling Work-Related Anxieties. I'm sure marami sa inyo ang can relate to this, or maybe on the girl side, stress drill on. So marami sa atin ang can relate with this, especially with the ongoing pandemic, no? So that is why we're very happy na itong ating last session for our OSH webinar series for Qualimed mental health ang ating discussion. All right, so without further ado, I'm sure a lot of our colleagues will be signing in a while. I am Bambi Picazo, your corporate training manager for work. So together with me, let me introduce us, and to welcome us this afternoon is our new COO or Chief Operating Officer of our Qualimed Manila facility, Team Qualimed and friends of Qualimed, let us all welcome Dr. Rizzy Alejandro.
Hi, Bambi. Thank you very much for that introduction. Good afternoon to everybody. Thank you very much to Bambi and Doc Gina for inviting me. I think ganun talaga pag bago, I looked at the list of all the people in the poster. It's myself, and Doc Angkoy Lopez is giving the closing remarks. He's also new, and Doc Nikki Bautista is the moderator for the Q&A, and she's also new. So I think may initiation ata dito, Bambi, na pag bago kailangan mautusan agad. I have to say this is the most creatively titled webinar that I have been to.
Dami
ko nang napuntahang webinar, and it's the first time that talagang creative na Hagardo Versosa. Kilala ko naman si Gardo Versosa. I just googled what he's doing now. Apparently, he's very famous on TikTok.
Yes, and he's cupcake.
Sumayaw. Yes. I cannot do any dancing. Maybe Doc Angkoy can do that later on, or Doc Nikki. But I see Bambi brought it up kanina, yung stress drill-on is another alternative title that I would have suggested. This will date me, but I love these terms. We used to use this a lot in med school. I think that's the height of the time that you're Hagardo and stress drill-on. But ang mga kasama niyan is, mahirap pag Hagardo ka na, tapos Tom Jones ka pa.
Ayan, correct.
Mahirap talaga yan. At saka, lalo na if sumasabay yung weather, diba? Jumujulanes Morissette. Yeah.
Oh, that's
so
right.
Yun yung mga favorite terms ko from our friends in LGBTQIA. But all joking aside, I think apart from being very catchy and memorable, this title also says a lot about how we Filipinos deal with mental health. No? May a lot of humor, may konting tendency to downplay or to dismiss, right? When there's some type of mental health concern or issue. And I think it's great that we are having this discussion today, because it really brings to light that mental health, even though we're culturally as Filipinos, we try to dismiss it, is a very real problem in our own communities. And sometimes we don't even have to look very far. It happens in our own homes, in our workplaces. I it's a very real problem. In a last time, a last year when I was still with AC Health, we actually looked into this and did a study on mental health. And I was so surprised. I found out that the mental health prevalence is very high. It's about 1 in 10 people will have some sort of mental health issue. So imagine there are 83 of us in this call right now. That means just among this group, there are probably around 8 people who are suffering from some form of mental health concern at the moment. And this pandemic has made it even worse. I was looking at statistics that show that at the height of the pandemic, the National Center for Mental Health actually received 2 times the normal calls for suicide because of just how difficult this pandemic has been, how very isolating it is. It has been for many patients who went through a difficult treatment, family members who have passed and family members who are left behind grieving. So mental health is very real. And I this is a topic close to my heart because just last year, one of our team members in AC Health actually went through some anxiety attacks because of work-related stress. And one of the things, well, I learned a few things from that I wanted to share with this group, and I thought it would be a good way to kick it off is, number one, it happens for people that you least expect, when you least expect it. This person, for instance, was one of our high performers, napakagaling, excellent, magaling sa trabaho, and hindi mo lang alam na internally they were going through so much already. The second thing that I learned is sometimes even the person themselves, they don't or cannot recognize yet the signs and the symptoms, right? They think they're doing okay, yun pala, ang dami ng mga red flags or mga symptoms that could have told them that you need to get help. And sometimes it's a matter of recognizing what those red flags are and what the signs and symptoms are. And the third thing I learned from that experience is we have to be very deliberate about how we address it. We cannot just dismiss it, or we cannot just say that, okay, we'll figure it out later on. We have to take very concrete steps, whether that's taking a break, planning a break, making sure that you get some rest. Number two, giving feedback to people or getting feedback to your manager that you need help with the workload, you need help with managing your time. And the third is giving access to mental health services. We don't need to pretend that we can do it all ourselves, no? And that's why I think it's such a great initiative that Rambi and her team have put together, because this mental health webinar is a way for us to get access to healthcare services, to at least be more aware about mental health, and especially as we encounter it in the workplace. Just credit to the team for organizing this. I hope all of us today in this call, we practice some form of mental health, rest, and wellness also. Just focus on today's session. Learn what you can. Don't multitask. Usually, dyan nagsisimula ang work-related stress. Pagka nagmumultitask tayo, ang daming deadlines, ang daming nangyayari. Let's take this time to deconnect ourselves, to unplug, and to really learn as much as we can from our speaker this afternoon. I'm sure it will be a great session for all of us, and I hope that it will equip us in the future, and it's something that we can look back on in case that we ourselves encounter these issues, or that we have a loved one or a coworker who will go through difficult times. So thank you very much, and I'm very happy to be here this afternoon. So great to see so many of my new team members here in QualiMed, actually the whole QualiMed. So QualiMed Manila and QualiMed. So thank you to everybody.
Thank you, Dr. Rizzi. Very nice. Welcome. Thank you for sharing your experience. So this is a very good way to really start off the session, because it's really just about talking about it, diba? So we need to be courageous enough to really share and talk about it. So to move forward, so may I just say to everybody, since this is our last of the series, that this program is actually brought to you by your corporate PSQM, led by Dr. Gina, corporate marketing, helping helped by Miss Day and Miss Thelma, and of course your corporate HR, no, with the help of all the HRs and all the everybody in the Qualimed, and we're very thankful to all the doctors who have had the chance to be with us in this series. Ayan, so to move forward, may I introduce to you our moderator. Like what Dr. Rizzi said, she is also new to the organization, but not really, since we've been working with her since last year, but officially as a Qualimed, very new. But since last year, we've been working with her through AVIP together with Dr. Rizzi. So she was a graduate of the Ateneo School of Medicine and Public Health. So she was a Strategy and External Affairs Associate of ACH. So dyan natin siya unang nakasama. No, and a Research Fellow of the DOH Health Technology Assessment Study Group. And she's doing Senior Research Assistants at the Ateneo Center for Health, Evidence, Action, and Leadership. So, ladies and gentlemen, Team Qualimed and friends of Qualimed, let me give you our Corporate Strategic Initiatives Manager, Ms. Dr. Nicole Bautista. Dr. Nikki.
Hello. Hi, Bambi. Thank you so much for that introduction. And thank you, Dr. Rizzi, for your wonderful opening remarks. And so Dr. Rizzi and I really worked so much together in the last 2 years.
The OG Hagardo Versosa.
Yes.
That's right.
We've seen each other in our most Hagardos, Hagardo and Stress Drillon versions of each other. Again, thank you, Dr. Rizzi, for that wonderful opening remarks. I'm very excited to introduce our speaker for the day and, of course, go on with the Q&A afterwards. Let me introduce Dr. Belen De Matata. She is an international fellow from the American Psychiatric Association and, of course, a fellow in the Philippine Psychiatric Association. He is also a consultant psychiatrist in many hospitals in the Batangas area. So, of course, in BMMC in Tanawan and surrounding hospitals like Lipa Medical and St. Francis Cabrini. She finished her residency training in National Center for Mental Health, and also finished her Doctor of Medicine degree from St. Louis University in Baguio City. She's also finished her Master's in Hospital Administration from St. Jude College, Manila. Ladies and gentlemen, let's all welcome Dr. Belen De Matata.
Good afternoon.
Good afternoon,
Doc. Hello, everyone. So it's nice to be here among all the young people around me. Sabi ko, babata niyo pa. So it's good to be here. Thank you for the invite. Last of the 5 webinar series. And I hope this will not be the list of the 5.
Yes, of course not.
Hope I will be able to impart as much knowledge na may share ko about mental health. Thank you, Dr. Rizzi and Dr. Nikki, for the warm welcome and the introduction. And it seems Dr. Rizzi made her research talaga. The burden of mental health is around 1 in every 10. But considering anxiety and depression, both of them account for an average of 3% each. So ganon katindi. And in this COVID era, in fact, most statistics reveal that there's a 25% increase in the cases of anxiety with the onset of this pandemic. So I think this topic is a very relevant issue today, knowing that anxiety is one of the most common mental health conditions in not only in the country, but in the whole world. If not in the whole universe, ha? So Pia Wurzbach naman tayo ngayon. So I think I will have to share my slide. So Bambi, can you see my my slides now?
Yes, Doctora, it's okay. Very clear.
My audio is clear?
Yes.
Okay, so again, thank you for this afternoon, for sharing your afternoon with me. And as I have mentioned to Barbie and Dr. Mickey a while ago, thank you for sharing my advocacy to share the advocacy of promoting mental health. So this afternoon, I was tasked to talk about anxiety. But with your indulgence, I would say that siguro for us to talk about mental health conditions in the workplace, like anxiety, siguro mas I opted to a little make the basics of the anxiety and talk about anxiety and stress, because all of the mental health conditions start with the level of stress that we have within all of us. So understanding the context of anxiety, sa totoo lang, hanggang ngayon, we in the mental health profession, we don't have yet the exact Tagalog definition of anxiety. Unlike depression, there's lungkot, lumbay, there's sadness, matinding lungkot, but anxiety, parang wala pa siyang exact Tagalog term. So, but if we understand the context of anxiety, siguro probably we can have some portions, some thoughts on ano talaga ba itatawag natin with anxiety. So, anxiety, it's a spectrum. Okay? There is also such a thing as normal anxiety. So, when we hear the word anxiety, it does not mean it's already a mental health condition. It may be a normal reaction to something. Usually, normal anxiety is related to a specific situation or a problem. It lasts only as long as there is a situation or as long the problem is there. The response of the person is proportional to the situation that he is involved in or the problem that he is facing with. And the response of that person is realistic compared to the realistic problem or situation. So this is a normal life situation. Kung normal anxiety, ako, I would probably refer a normal anxiety to a stress. Yung stress natin, when we talk of stress, di ba, related to a specific situation, it is time limited. It is proportional to the situation and it's realistic. Knowing that we are stressed, sabi nga kanina ni Bambi, stress drill on. So knowing that we are stressed, maybe it's a normal form of anxiety. So when we talk of spectrum, kung hindi mo maayos yung response mo to a particular problem or situation, the anxiety now becomes prolonged. The anxiety now becomes intense and severe, that the feeling of apprehension, uncertainty, and fear becomes exaggerated now. That's the emotional component. So when there is an exaggerated feeling of apprehension, uncertainty, and fear, of course, there's an unpleasant state of tension. So yung stress level natin, umaangat na siya. In anticipation of an imminent danger. Parang there's a threat. And when there's a threat, it's a very, very unpleasant state. And there's already, kung stress kanina, it now becomes tense. So yung tension niya, if you can imagine a rubber band, normally rubber band, when you pull it, so it becomes stretched. And the bigger the pressure, the more tense the rubber becomes. So pareho din yun ang yung state of emotions natin. The longer that we hold on to that stress, it becomes more unpleasant and unpleasant. And of course, if there's an emotional component, of course, our body will also react to it. So there's associated muscle tension. And you now become alert and vigilant to prepare for what is threatening us. We tend to be cautious, or on the other hand, we tend to be avoidant. We are trying to avoid situations like kung ano yung mga situations na we have been in. So that's anxiety. There's just a threat. So there's nothing specific. There's always uncertainty. And you do not know what causes that. Okay? Versus when we talk of fear, the fear is an emotional response to a real or perceived threat. So, na-identify mo na ngayon yung stimulus. You fear, ano bang fear? Yung mga phobias, di ba? You fear being scolded. You fear going out at night. You fear blood, di ba? So yung fear, there's a threat. There's a real threat. There is a stimulus that triggers the negative emotion. So when there is fear, there is also a heightened arousal. Diba? Kung may kinakatakutan ka, ano ba ang normal response natin? You fight or flight. You fight the situation. Hindi, kaya ko to. Or, hindi na lang muna, iiwasan ko na lang. Diba? Because yung flight mode mo, yung thoughts of immediate danger, so you're going to escape. Yun yung tinatawag ko na iwas pusoy. Diba? You do not face the problem, but rather find an escape route to not deal with the situation right away. Okay? So yun yung spectrum ng anxiety. Hindi lahat ng anxiety can be considered abnormal. Kasi part of normal anxiety, maybe yun lang yung stress level na nararamdaman natin. So I opted to talk about stress so we will know the basics. Kung ano ba yung pinagdadaanan. So this is not just related to work, but related to our own individual personality. When we talk of stress, this stress is the general term applied to the pressure people feel in life. This according to Newstorm. So lahat ng may pressure, that's stress already. Kasi you put pressure and there is stress. Okay? And one accountable statement that can be made is stress belongs to everyone. I think in this forum, I am sure na in walang nakakalibre sa atin na magkaroon ng stress in our everyday life. So stress is part of our daily living, is part of every one of us, because it is our response to a perceived threat or challenge. Any change na mangyayari sa atin will automatically become parang pwede siyang matawag na stressful, pwede siyang matawag na stress, or simply a challenge. Diba? Any change. Example, any change in body temperature na lang. Okay? So when you have fever. Okay? So that's stress already. Naku, baka may COVID na ako. Naku, baka meron akong infectious disease. Diba? Change of workstation. Now, from now on, you will be assigned to this, to this department. Okay? So, paano ba yan? I will be with another group of people. Hindi ko naman sila kasundo. So it's a change, no? Change in residence, change in marital status. So all of these changes can bring out stress in ourselves. And it is now part of the challenge for us to cope, to be able to deal with the changes that happens to us. Kaya yung change nagiging challenge. Okay? Stress, of course, lagi namang may pinanggagalingan. Okay. A lot of people that I talk to, especially patients, no? most of them, or kahit hindi patients, kahit office workers, yung mga nasa ospital, nakakasalom, ay naku, umaga pa lang, stress na ako, di ba? So sometimes, ay kasi ano, I woke up on the wrong side of the bed. Pero if you look at it, kung titingnan natin, if we analyze, no, lagi namang sabi ko, there is always a reason for something eh. Even stress, even the stresses that we feel. Okay, so yung cause, ang tawag doon stressor. Okay? Siguro na traffic ka, siguro pag-ising mo, naglaba ka kahapon, hindi natuyo. Siguro tinawag ka ni boss mo, oy tapusin mo to. Ito yung deadline mo ngayon, eh kabibigay lang na 4 o'clock, deadline mo, eh alas 5, uwian na kayo, may date ka pa ng alas 5. So yan, demands of your bosses, demands of the work from, yung mga work from home. Diba? Demands from the family, yung mga anak mo. Kasi yung akala natin yung work from home status, ang sarap ano. Pero parang nadodoble yung ano mo, nadodoble yung stress mo because aside from yung demands from the work, yung parang wala nang delineation yung demand of the family. Kasi nandun na yung mga anak mo lahat, magpapaturo pa ng module, magpapaturo pa ng assignment sa'yo. Tapos, yung boss mo, oh, ito, tapusin mo na to, ha? Kailangan ko na to, i-submit mo na to, ha? Kailangan ko na report mo, nagganyan. So, it becomes now, it's all demanding and it becomes a very, very big, huge pressure for us to be able to cope. Okay? So, lahat may pinanggagalingan. Okay? So, if I will ask each one of you na nandito, okay? Ano ba yung major work and life stressors mo? Okay? Is it primarily your work? Ano ba nakaka-stress sa work mo? Yung bang boss mo? Yung bang dati gusto natin mag-work from home, ngayon ayaw mo na, sawa ka na, pwede ba, Dok? Pwede ba, sir? Pwede bang pumasok na lang? Mas gusto ko yata na everyday aalis ako para at least hindi na ako nasa bahay kasi nabibingi na ako sa mga gulo sa bahay, magluluto pa ako, magre-report pa ako, yung alam mo yun, all of this. Okay? Is this the problem with your health? Or health of the family member? Is it about financial matters? Is it about your family? Is it about relationship? Or marami pwedeng maging stressors. Pero ang importante, before we deal with work-related problems, Siguro to ha, tip ko lang sa inyo to ha, once in a while, you do some self-talk. Huwag lang masyado malakas ha. Huwag, yung sabi parang nasa, parang ngayon lang no, parang nagsasalita ako mag-isa. Pero hindi, kidding aside, lalo na tayo no, we are at Qualimed, we're exposed to hospital work, we do a lot of chit-chat or talking with patients, relatives, with everyone. But lagi nating tinatanong, oh, kumusta na po kayo? Di ba? Kung pasyente, oh, kumusta po? Ano pong nagbago? Ano pong ganyan? Pero have you in your lifetime asked yourself, how am I doing? Di ba? Kumusta na ba ako? In my own assessment, ha? In your own assessment of yourself, that's a little parang health and happiness inventory yon. Okay? So are you satisfied with life? How are you doing? How is your health doing? How is your relationship doing? How are you coping with your work? So yung mga work, kasi minsan nakakalimutan na natin yung sarili natin. Na hindi na natin nakakamusta kasi nakakamusta natin yung asawa natin, yung boyfriend natin, nakakamusta natin yung ka-office mate natin, pero hindi naman selfishness yon na paminsan-minsan you try to talk to yourself, oh nga no, lalo na sa gabi before you go to bed, okay, how am I? How did I do? Did I fare well? Did I extend my helping hand to that somebody in need na nakita ko kanina? How did I feel about it? Masaya ba ako na nakatulong? O masaya ba akong dinedma ko lang siya? So all of these things, at least kamustahin mo yung sarili mo. Kasi kung walang mga musta sa'yo, at least alam mo sa sarili mo how you're doing. And mababawasan na yung mga stressors mo sa buhay pag alam mo how you have been handling your own life. Okay. So ito yung sinasabi ko kasi yung stresses natin may be triggered by both internal and external stressors. Okay? Within you, yon yung mga belief, yung mga pamahiin, yung pagiging independent, yung sa naku, hindi ako pwede pag wala ka, hindi ako pwede na hindi ako masaya, kailangan may taga-turo lagi sa akin, kailangan may laging may aalalay sa akin, pag nawala ka na, wala na ako, di ba? So yung negative thoughts dito, it can trigger, di ba? Naku, baka mamaya, di ba? Pagkang katulad ngayon, pag ako negative ako, sabi ko baka wala makinig sa akin ah. Baka walang matuwa sa sasabihin ko ah. Kasi wala namang pwede mag-react eh. Kasi mga profile pic lang nakikita ko eh. Diba? Kung negative ako, it will be a stressor to me. No? So, hindi lang yun dito. In all other aspects of your life. So, yun ang sabi ko earlier na you talk about yourself. Am I being too negative about myself or about other people? Diba? Tama ba yung mga iniisip ko about myself or other people? Okay? So that's the internal. Kaya sabi ko yung internal, eh bahala ka na. Bahala ka to take care of yourself. And don't regard it as something that's quite selfish. Kasi ikaw yun eh. Walang ibang magmamahal sa'yo. Unang-una, ikaw yun eh. Diba sabi nila, ang unang-unang magmamahal sa'yo, magulang mo. Pero hindi naman ako nagdi-disagree, but kahit mahal ka ng magulang mo, hindi mo mararamdaman yon kung hindi mo mahal yung sarili mo. Diba? Kasi yun nga sinasabi naman, there's no love to give kung wala kang love sa sarili mo. Kaya kinakailangan yung internal, aalagaan natin yon. Dapat kabisado natin yung takbo. Pero walang dayaan ha, walang dayaan. Baka mamaya dayain yung sarili. Hindi, okay lang ako. Naku, hindi naman ako negative. Wala namang nega sa akin. Diba? So that's the internal. On the external, ito yon, pwedeng sa work. Pwedeng sa relationships mo with your coworkers. Diba? Difficult coworker nakalagay dito. Meron pala naman difficult boss. Ay, parang wala na akong ginawang tama sa boss ko. Parang lahat naman ang gawin ko ay mali, pero ito naman kasama ko, pareho naman kami nito. Bakit sa kanya very good, ako hindi? Di ba? Paperworks, deadlines, so mainit masyado. Naku, sa office namin dyan sa Qualimed, parang ang init-init. So pwedeng external yun kasi stressor din sa'yo that you cannot work comfortably. Or maybe masyado malakas naman yung aircon, kailangan mo pang mag-jacket, no? Para... para ma-overcome mo yung masyadong lamig. So lahat ng yon, at least alam mo, nararamdaman mo, and you should do something about it. Yun yung mga triggers. Okay. So, pag may trigger tayo, anong nangyayari sa atin? Diba? Pwede siya magkaroon ng negative or positive outcome. Hindi lahat ng stress ay negative yun. Diba? Kasi yung negative, doon muna tayo sa positive. Ano ba yung positive? May stress ba naman doktor ang positive? Of course, there is. Kasi lagi naman there are always two sides of a coin. So positive or eustress, ito yung healthy ways natin to combat the stress. To cope. Ito yung ginagawa natin para malampasan natin kung ano yung pinagdadaanan natin. Example, sa work, mayroong deadline ang boss mo, di ba? 10 report na kailangan, di ba? In a matter of 2 hours. Naku naman, hindi naman realistic yan, boss, di ba? Kasi parang maghapon na yata ako ganito, hapon na naman, di ba? So, natetense ka na, na-stress ka na, but if you're able to overcome, natapos mo, siguro a little delay, pero natapos mo rin, hi, salamat, boss, ito na yung report ko, please accept my report. O, pag na very good ka, ay, salamat. So, nawala si stress mo. And that becomes a positive stress kasi nadagdagan yung confidence mo. Eh, kaya ko naman pala. Akala ko in that short span of time, hindi ko kayang gawin. Pero kaya ko naman pala. So nadagdagan yung confidence mo, na-boost yung self-esteem mo, and in a way, it becomes now a positive kind of stress. Yung distress o yung negative, Ito naman yung unhealthy. This unhealthy, so it becomes destructive. Anong ibig sabihin ng unhealthy? Pag alam mo na yung stress, identified mo yung stress, but you're not doing anything about it, isip ka lang ng isip, paano kaya to? Na deadline na ng bayadan. Bayaran ko sa ganito, sa Meralco, sa ganito, sa bills ko, lahat-lahat. Diba? O kaya tapos, yung ganito ko, ang dami ko pang gagawin, ang dami ko pa nakapila, may tuition pa, etc., etc. Pag-isip ka lang ng isip and you're not doing anything about it, it becomes a distress kasi you're not doing something to cope or to give an answer, to give a solution to that something that gives you stress. So, pagka laging ganun ang iniisip mo, it now becomes a distress. Yun yung sinasabi ko din when patients come to me, no, who are very, kasi pagka yung distress ka na, it now becomes part of the anxiety na lumalalim na siya. Okay? So, pansinin ninyo, when you feel stress, na lagi nyo sinasabi na i-stress kayo, at parating wala nang lumalaman dito, puro problema. Most likely, hindi mo sinusundan ano kayang pwedeng solusyon. What can be the solution to this thing na kinakaharap ko ngayon? So it becomes a distress, and distress that becomes prolonged now becomes anxiety. So yung how we respond to each particular kind of stress is also influenced the way we look at that particular situation. So, in a way, anything, any event, any situation that comes our way, kunyari, sampu tayo, may particular situation, not all 10 of us will look at that something, that event, na pare-pareho tayo ng interpretation. Sometimes, more often than not, out of the 10, iba-iba yung tingin mo do sa sitwasyon. Yung iba, we will look at that event as something plain, something na ano, yung sa iba, naku, problema yan, pagka ganito, ganyan, o diba? So, yung response natin depende on our own personality. And the next few slides, ito. Tingnan nyo ha, where you belong. Yung stress response type. Okay. May tatlong klaseng tao. Okay. Who respond to stress differently. The hot reactors, ito yon. They get sick in the battle. In the middle of the situation, in the middle of the problem, they get sick. Marami silang nararamdaman, masakit ang ulo, masakit yung dibdib, hindi na makatulog, hindi na makakain in the middle of that stressful situation. Okay? Yung sustainers, they get sick after. Pag natapos na yung stress, kunyari, meron kayong, ano ba yung mga typical na mga stressful, ano? Kunyari, merong activity sa hospital. Diba? Ikaw yung in charge. Yung HR ang in charge. Diba? Yung iba, naku, paano kaya ito? Ang dami kong gagawin. Pero when you are a sustainer, you are able to do all the things. Na-prepare mo lahat. Pero pagkatapos, ay naku, parang pagod na pagod ako ha. Ang dami kong ginawa during all the preparation. And you get sick after, yun yung sustainers. Yung hardy na tinatawag, ito wala lang. Ginagawa nila yung dapat, namamanage nila without getting sick. Diba? So, sa tatlong ito, alin ang gusto mo o alin ka dito sa tatlo? Okay? So, yan yung part of the ano self-talk na sinasabi natin. Alamin mo, anong klase ka, what type, how do you respond to the stresses that come your way? Are you a hot reactor? Are you a sustainer? Or are you the hardy type? Okay. Ito daw yung hot reactors. Sabi natin, nagkakasakit sila, no? In the middle of the game, in the middle of the stress. Ito yan. ang dami pala, no? One in every five people. Ito yung mga tumataas ang BP. Pa-BP mo nga ako, parang tumataas. Parang ako'y pagod na eh. Parang ganyan, no? Tapos laging galit, maintang ulo, di ba? So ito yung sinasabi natin, parang mga type A, no? So these people are subject to heart disease, stroke, and sudden death. Kasi nga, hindi sila nare-relax at lagi silang parang tensionado. Sustainers naman, ito, yung let down effect. Pagkatapos na ng lahat, pag nag-change na yung gear from yung parang mataas yung adrenaline mo, tapos biglang bababa na, tapos na eh, tapos na yung activity, tapos na lahat ng gagawin mo, tsaka ka naman makakaramdam ng parang napagod yata ako, ha? Parang, di ba? Especially pagka yun daw ha, yung long weekends, long vacations, 'di ba? Pag nag-holiday ka, pag nagbabakasyon ka, parang pagod na pagod ka. Ako parang gusto ko ulit magbakasyon kasi galing ako sa mahabang bakasyon. Napagod sa bakasyon. 'Di ba? Or after retirement, 'di ba? 'Di ba pagka ikaw ay nagwo-work for so long, parang gustong-gusto mo, parang gusto ko yata nang hindi na nagre-report sa work, no? Pero pag nag-retire ka, parang pagod na pagod ka naman kasi wala kang magawa habang ikaw ay nasa retirement. Okay? Just like siguro ang example ko rito, ano, during the lockdown, di ba? Parang at first, tuwan-tuwa tayo, walang pasok, naku, lockdown, walang aalis, bahay lang, di ba? So akala natin 1 week lang. So masaya tayo, walang ginagawa. Pero after a week, after 2 weeks, 3 weeks, 4 weeks, naku, lahat ng tao nagreklamo na, di ba? So parang humahaba yung period of uncertainty natin. So ito naman yung ano, ito yung sana lahat, sana all, no? Yung hardy. Kasi parang wala lang, nag-work, pero less lang yung stress, di ba? May health habits ka, may strong social support, tapos hindi ka madaling mag-react sa mga tao, tapos laging optimistic yung view mo of the world, tapos magaling kang mag-cope from all, marunong kang maglaro sa mga sitwasyon. Kaya you don't feel stress at all. Okay. When you are stressed, ito, sa HR, marami pa tayong empleyado. Parating ito ang complain. Diba? Back pain, all, parang sa stress, kung mapapansin nyo, parang all kinds of pain. Back pain, headache, chest pain, back pain, muscles spasm. Most often ganyan, hindi na ma-identify kasi lagi o nagda-diarrhea. So kung mapapansin nyo lahat ng symptoms na ito, include all the bodily organs. Most often, gastric, no? Parang may gastritis, upset, GERD, nausea. So parang lahat ng, actually, more often, yung mga pasyenteng nare-refer sa amin, matagal na silang tinitreat for GERD. Pero hindi sila gumagaling. Baka, ayun, stress sila. Pero kung mapapansin nyo later, pansinin nyo ha yung signs and symptoms ng stress. How this is related to anxiety. Psychological signs of stress. No? Pag na-stress ka na, ito, madali ka na magalit, madali kang mainip. You notice yung anxiety kasi anxiety is both a symptom and a diagnosis eh. So pwede kang maging anxious, hopeless, you feel depressed, you feel irritable, you feel easily frustrated, you become impatient, and you feel always rejected. Yun yung psychological signs when you feel that you are, ito yung mga so much stressed. Ha? Behavioral signs. Sa ngayon, hindi na siya masyado. Yung behavioral signs na parang ganyan, parang hindi makasalita, o parang, alam nyo yun, yung pag, sa HR siguro, yung pag nag-i-interview kayo, nagtatap, yung paa yung gumaganyan, yung paa niya. Tapos, kaya, ganyan ang ganyan, tapos, mapapansin nyo yun eh, when you look at people, parang hindi siya relax, no? Yung iba, yung napapansin ko, yung, alam nyo yun dito, yung parang gumaganyan, yung pag nagsasalita siya, yung gumaganda, pero hindi nila nanonotice yun. Pero most often, these people are stressed. Pansinin nyo yung mga kausap nyo. O pansinin nyo yung katabi nyo. So, okay. So, the key is not to avoid stress. Kasi ayaw nga natin na iwas pusoy. Diba? But to manage the stress in all our lives so that we avoid the negative consequences of stress. Okay? Not to avoid. Therefore, sige lang. Kakayanin. But to manage. Okay? So, bakit, ano bang i-avoid natin? What are the negative consequences of stress? Dito na papasok ngayon yung remember the spectrum that I talked about a little earlier? Dito na papasok ngayon yung anxiety. Kasi pag yung stress mo na stretch, tumagal, na prolong, na severe, it now becomes an anxiety. Okay? And it becomes an anxiety disorder pag ang worry mo is excessive, sobra, kahit anong bagay, nagwo-worry ka, na nagko-cause ng pagkabalisa, you become restless because of the unnecessary worry. Siyempre, pag lagi kang worried, if you become restless, madali ka rin mapagod, you become easily fatigued, parang wala ka pang ginagawa, eh pagod na pagod ka na. You have trouble concentrating, you become irritable, sleep is affected, and there's muscle tension. Alam niyo yung muscle tension? Yun nga, kagaya sabi ko yung parang gumaganyan. O din sa iba, parang yung nagaganyan yung muscle, kaya maraming back pains. At pag lahat ng ito naranasan mo most days for more than 6 months, at nakakaabala na to in your everyday life, ito na ngayon ang generalized anxiety disorder. Maraming tao can live with this disorder kasi hindi naman siya life-threatening. In fact, marami ring tao na living with the anxiety disorder, nagpapagamot naman sila, but hindi sila nagpapagamot to a mental health professional kasi hindi naman nila nalalaman na baka anxiety to. So they go to internist, they go to gastroenterologist, pulmonologist, lahat ng doktor napuntahan na. Pag lahat ng doktor napuntahan na, mag-iisip na yung attending niya, baka anxiety yan kasi all systems are clear. So pag walang mahanap na cause, most likely it's an anxiety disorder. Anong nangyayari sa tao? Ito yung itsura. So yan, puro worry to, di ba? Yan ang si Hagardo, introducing to you, Hagardo versus. So it differs now from normal stress and anxiety kasi it, as I have repeatedly said, it is more severe, it is prolonged, and it interferes with work and relationship. Okay? So kung mapapansin nyo, di ba sabi ko kanina, look at the physical symptoms of stress. Di ba? Parang pareho lang naman ang symptoms ng anxiety. Di ba? So, strange vision, sleep disturbance, feeling breathless, nausea, lack of appetite, restless trembling, palpitations, sweating, di ba? Parang namamawis, nanlalamig, di ba? Parang kinakabog. So, lahat. So, similar to the physical symptoms of stress. Kaya sabi ko, spectrum yan. Di ba? Kaya lang, pag yung stress mo, kunyari, yung meron kasi akong pasyente, sabi niya, kasi madali, pag ginugulat ako talaga nagugulantang, sabi ko. Sabi ko, normal naman yan. Kasi alam nga naman, nagulating ka, tapos nakaganyan ka. Di ba? Parang hindi, yun ang mas hindi normal. Pero kung ginulat ka, and you reacted na parang nagulat ka, kinabog ka, napatayo ka, it's normal. Kaya lang, kung nagugulat ka nang wala namang stimulus, iba na yun. Di ba? Yung kalimitan sa mga may anxiety disorders, especially for the elderly, sasabihin nung kamag-anak, ewan ko nga ho ba dyan, worry ng worry, wala naman hong dapat problemahin. Yun ang anxiety kasi hindi mo matukoy kung ano na yung dapat mong pinoproblema. Okay? So marami, especially sa mga sa mga gerya. Although ngayon, tumataas din even the young adults. Marami akong pasyente na young adults that kasabihin nila, doktora, dati po ang galing-galing ko sa office, pero ngayon parang hirap na ako. May mga senior managers ako na pasyente. May teachers ako na in their doctoral course. Doktora, simula nung nag-online, parang hindi ko na kayang gawin. So imagine ha, pero alam mo naman, based on their qualification, wala naman dahilan para bumaba yung level of capacity nila. Yun nga lang, nagkakaroon sila ng anxiety. Kaya nila nararamdaman yung mga nararamdaman nila. Okay. So why are we talking naman about depression? Kasi yung depression is still part of the spectrum. Diba? Kalimitan, persons with anxiety almost always have depression beneath. Parang laging may underlying depression ang mga taong may anxiety. Okay? Pero hindi lahat ng depression pwedeng magkaroon ng anxiety symptoms. Pwedeng depressed symptoms lang. Although, meron din namang depressive people na may anxiety symptoms. Pero almost all anxiety cases have underlying depression. Kasi pag yung anxiety mo, hindi pa rin gumaling, humaba, panang humaba, it now becomes depression. Kasi part of the spectrum ng negative. Anong commonality nila? Yung negative thoughts and negative emotions. Ang commonality, humahaba, tumatagal. So from stress, normal stress, naging distress, naging anxiety disorder, going to depression. Yun ang ayaw natin kasi baka yung depression mapunta pa dun sa ayaw natin, which is suicidality. Kaya ang ating ngayon is the promotion of mental health. We go back to the basics. We should know about what stress is, what stresses us, and to be able to cope. Yun ang purpose natin this afternoon. Okay, so if you will also look at the symptoms, signs and symptoms of depression, di ba? If you will look closely, pareho na naman ng symptoms ng stress and anxiety, di ba? Ito, sa cognition, attention, poor concentration, poor ang memory mo, poor ang decision making, poor ang planning. So lahat ito poor kasi nga depressed ka. Mahina na yung pag-iisip mo. Ito, emotionality, yun lang ang ikinaiba ng depression. Lumalim na siya kasi nga mas tumagal na siya. So what happens to your emotion? Negative emotion pero mas lumalim. When we talk of depression, wala. Bagsak ka, gulap. Ano yun sa Tagalog? Lugmok. Nalugmok ka na. So ano, sadness. Ay, ano ba yan? Sadness, lack of enjoyment, parati kang guilt-laden. Ito yung ayaw namin, may suicidality. Hopeless, you become hopeless. And you lack enjoyment. Parang wala ka ng saya sa buhay. You lack interest in everything that you do. Pero, so that's emotion, feelings, thoughts, cognition, and physical. Look at the symptoms of the physical. Pareho rin to. Nung stress, pareho din to ng depression. Headaches, stomach problem, all kinds of pain, psychomotor agitation, sleep problem, pwedeng tulog ng tulog, pwedeng hindi ka makatulog, fatigue, pagod, pwede kang hindi makakain or kain ka ng kain, yung stress eating, o pwede kang magkaroon ng sexual dysfunction. Kaya sabi ko, all of those stress, anxiety, and depression are all interrelated. Okay, so kagaya ng nasabi ko, anxiety and depression are on the rise. Nag-increase by 25%. Okay, so ito, American census, that for every 100 Americans, 34 show symptoms of anxiety, depression, or both. 10 out of 100, so 1 out of 10, pareho din yung kanina na kinuwento ni Dr. Easy, 1 out of 10 may anxiety, 4 out of 100 nag-show ng depression alone. Pero sabi ko nga, almost all anxiety cases have underlying depression. So yan. So what we now go to the ano. So kung naintindihan na natin ang stress, sabi natin kanina, do not avoid, wag iwas po siya. So what can we do? So stress, we can work. Stress can work for us and not against us. Okay. The most important thing that you should know is awareness. Lahat ng kailangan natin, kailangan aware ka of what's happening to you. When you're aware, you now have the motivation to change. Diba? Kasi not unless you become aware of something, you will not do anything about it. Diba? So pag aware ka of what is happening, then you feel motivated to do some changes. And kalakip na niyan yung emotional intelligence to accept. Kung pangit yung awareness mo, kung pangit yung tingin mo, then maybe accept mo, ah, oo, I need to change for the better. So, importante yan to be able to change your behavior. Napagod na yata. May question ba kayo? Okay. So, kung alam na natin yung aware, kung if we are aware, if we are motivated, ang kailangan nating ma-develop within each one of us is the resilience. Ano ba yung resilience? It involves maintaining flexibility and balance in your life. Ibig sabihin, alam mong mag-adjust. Okay? So I think yung resilience is synonymous also with yung adaptability, yung kakayahan mo na maging flexible in all kinds of situations so you can deal with it however stressful or traumatic the events may be. Nadidevelop din yan yung resilience. Okay. Ito naman, ito yung kanina, di ba kung napansin nyo, yung the hardy, yung hardy na tao. Ano bang kailangan nating matutunan? Ito, hindi lang ito with regards to work ethics, no? Kasi ang pinag-uusapan natin ngayon is work-related. But if we will be able to apply this in our own individual lives, palagay ko kahit hindi sa work, you will be very confident and happy ka sa buhay mo. Okay. Number one, sabi natin kanina, yung change equals stress. Any change, pwede siyang mag-cause ng stress. Then we have to view change as a challenge, 'di ba? Rather than a threat. 'Di ba? Kung lilipat ka ng department, 'di ba? Naku naman, sir. 10 years na ako dito, ililipat mo pa ba ako? 'Di ba? Para namang galit ka ba sa akin? Ba't ililipat mo ko, 'di ba? Pero sabihin mo sa sarili mo, okay, I will accept the challenge. Baka it's time for me to meet new colleagues. Baka yung department na to, iba yung dating. So, 'di ba? Baka it may not be a promotion, lateral entry, baka it's time for me to learn something new, 'di ba? So that's, kung papansinin niyo, it's a more positive way of accepting that change. Pag inaccept mo sa challenge, okay? You should be committed. Nagagawin mo yung mga activities na dating ayaw mo, parang you will give it a try. 'Di ba? Ay, ayaw ko na. Hindi ko kaya. Hindi ko gusto. 'Di ba? Pero kung itatry mo, pag kasi hindi mo tinry, you become alienated with all these activities. Hindi mo pa naman nasubukan eh, malay mo. Bekene men. 'Di ba? So, you try to be committed with all the little things or big things that will be assigned to you whether at work or at home. Okay? Possess a more internal focus of control. Tayo ang magko-control sa sarili natin. Diba? We become more optimistic. So, i-explain natin. Parang, ito yung sinasabi ko, in every circumstance, whether bad, traumatic, whether problem, always find something good in it. Diba? Whatever trauma, pwede kang maghanap ng something good. something good in it. Na parang sa lahat ng events, meron at meron ka namang mahahanap na ano. Meron at meron kang mahahanap na ano, na something good. Okay? Yung ating self-esteem, yung kakayahan mo na gumawa, 'di ba? Para tumaas yung job satisfaction mo and job performance mo. Yun ang sinasabi ko na tingnan mo rin yung paligid mo. Buhayin mo yung kakayahan mo to do things. Kasi pag yung self-esteem mo, yung pagkilala mo sa sarili mo, mataas, equivalent also that to confidence. Confident ka na you will be able to do or be more productive do sa mga jobs na ina-assign sa'yo. Why are we doing all of this? Because kung nagagawa natin to sa ating sarili, di ba? Yung pansarili natin, individual lives natin. Pag masaya ka, satisfied ka, confident ka about your life, kahit anong work ang ibigay sa'yo, masaya mong tatanggapin eh. There will be less burnout sa work. Yung parang tuwing papasok ka, parang there's always, kahit 10 taon ka na sa trabaho, no? 10 taon mo nang ginagawa yung job mo, there's always something new na pwede mo magawa. May something new to offer ka to sa everyday na pagpasok mo. So yun yung mga cognitive yung mga thoughts natin that will add sa pagiging hardy person natin. Okay. So aside from that, ito basic naman to eh. Nasabi na rin to kanina ni Dr. Rizzi, we do a lot of exercise, we sleep more, we eat proper food, you should avoid alcohol. Kasama to sa webinar kanina, di ba? Ay, yung mga nakalipas, alcohol and smoking. So yung nutrition, sabi nila, hindi ka daw magbabawas ng mga healthy foods. Kasi di ba, yung iba nagbabawas ng food. Ang i-avoid mo daw yung mga junk food. You provide adequate rest and sleep. Maraming bata ngayon, natutulog sila umaga na. Kasi nag-gadget, naglalaro. Pero all of this, pag mas less yung sleeping time mo, nagtitrigger na yun not only mental health problems, but also physical problems, medical problems. So how do we cope? Ito, relaxation. Both, ha? So relaxation, hindi lang physical. Kailangan natin ng mental kasi yung mental relaxation, yun yung mag-aalis ng mga worries na siyang trigger ng anxiety, stress, depression. So meditation, breathing exercises, and time out from, teka muna, wait lang muna ha, I will breathe. Time out muna ako sa problema kasi aalisin ko muna sa isip ko. Diba? Physical relaxation, stretching, sports, aerobics. Siguro sa company naman, sa Qualimed naman, we also provide sports fest. Kaya may mga sports fest sa ano, sa mga company, sa offices. Yung massage, hindi na masyado yata ngayon kasi nag-pandemic. Pero you can do stretching, sports, and aerobics. Itong managing, ito yung sinasabi ko kanina, kung mag-self-talk tayo, no? You also keep, nung unang panahon kasi, nung panahon namin, merong journal, may journal tawag namin na slam book. Yung slam book, yun lang, tatanungin ka. Pero sa akin, to be able to manage yung stress mo, yung journal mo, ang tawag ko doon ay feel good journal. Para hindi ka, when you're burned out kasi, when you don't feel good at the end of the day, matutulog ka, you're not feeling good kasi nga may pangit na nangyari sa'yo. Pero kung titingnan mo na lang, 'di ba sabi ko, always find something good. 'Di ba? So keep a journal, write 3 things na nangyari sa isang maghapon that made you feel good. Kahit ano simple, kasi I was able to walk 1 kilometer, or I was able to chit-chat with my friend. I was able to drink milk tea kanina. Yung alit, kahit konti, ay masaya ako because I feel good because ay nakapaglaba ako ng marami kasi hindi siya umulan. Yung mga little things na yon na hindi mo napapansin, pero pag sinulat mo and when you go back to it, mapapangiti ka. Kasi ayo pala, tinex pala ako nung friend ko, matagal ko nang hindi nakikita. So yung mga little things na yon, if you keep a journal, that becomes a record na pag binalikan mo, you feel good, ayo nga, di ba? So sabi ko nga, 1-3 lang. Pero if you can write more, tsaka huwag mo tingnan yung sinulat mo kahapon, baka mangopya ka. Ang isulat mo na lang yung anything that comes to your mind, lalo na bago ka matulog, or any time of the day that you feel like writing. Marami akong pasyente, no? Sabi ko, ganyan, pagbalik sa akin, ang nakalagay, uminit ang ulo ko kasi ganda sa akin. Feel good ba yun? Parang hindi naman. Ayokong basahin niya. Huwag mong basahin yan. Sasabihin niya ay, sabi ko, ang gusto kong ilagay mo, yung something that made you feel good. Being physically active also is one. Diba? All, lagi naman yan, both medical and mental, kailangan natin yan. And you pamper yourself. Kung magse-self-talk tayo, na kinakamusta natin sarili, then also ask yourself, ano bang gusto mo? Diba? Is there anything that you want? May wish ka pa ba? May bucket list ka pa ba? Ay, kahit na masimple, parang gusto ko. Ano pa ba yung gusto mo? Kailangan meron pa rin tayong little goals. No matter how young or how old we are, huwag kayong mawawala ng purpose, ng goal, ng gustong gawin. Okay? Social support, this support, ito yung mga kabagang, ito yung mga dabarkads, ito yung mga people na we know can provide support emotionally, mentally sa atin. Pwede mo lang masabihan ng problema, pwede mo titingnan mo lang silang, ingitian ka lang, and that's social support also. Okay, so ito, to summarize, hindi lang ito sa work ha, but in our everyday living. To maintain a positive attitude for a balanced, fulfilled life. Bakit ba natin kailangan ng balanced, fulfilled life? Kasi nga, pag balanced ka, pag fulfilled ka, kahit saan ka dalahin, sa trabaho man, o sa simbahan man, o kung saan man, masaya ka wherever you are and whatever you do. Okay? So ano yung sikreto? Number one, enjoy the now moment. Kalimitan sa nai-stress, kalimitan sa mga anxious o may anxiety problems, kalimitan sa mga depressed, they tend to look back at the past na hindi naman maganda. They tend to worry about the future na hindi pa nangyayari, na nag-a-anticipate sila ng pangit. So naiwan yung present, naiwan yung now. So they will not enjoy the now kasi nga worried about the past. Hindi, traumatized about the past, worried about the future. So what happens to the now? Wala. Worry pa rin. You don't enjoy. So number one tip, enjoy the now moment. Be at the moment. Kung ano meron ka, maging masaya ka. Kung anong, huwag kang maghanap ng wala. Kasi sabi ko nga, yung past, past na yan eh. Ano bang mangyayari? Kung may pangit ma, learn some good lessons from the past. And work better to have a better future. Do not worry about something na wala pa kasi ikaw din naman ang gagawa nun. Diba? If you're enjoying the now moment, you will be able to slow down and enjoy those around you. Diba? Yung mga hindi mo napapansin na halaman sa kapaligiran mo, napapansin mo na ngayon. Diba? Kaya nga napansin natin yung mga halaman dati, diba? Nung last year, at 2 years ago, nagmahal yung mga halaman kasi biglang nakita ng mga tao, ay, ang ganda pala nito. Ay, pwede pala ibenta ito. So, yun. You slow down, enjoy the good nature around us. Number 3, which is very important, always have that feeling of gratefulness sa puso natin. Whatever it is, make it a practice to be grateful, to appreciate the good things na binigay yung ibang tao sa atin. A simple thank you is a sign of gratefulness and appreciation. Doon sa taxi na sinakyan mo, sa Grab driver na nag-deliver, sa Food Panda, sa tricycle, sa kung saan man, you say thank you. And yung thank you mo, pag na-thank youhan mo sila, yung thank you mo, magte-thank you rin sila. So it will be a grateful life for all of us. Sa atin mag-uumpisa yun. And yun, kung thankful ka, masaya ka kasi naging di ba? Message of thanks eh. And then you learn something new. Sabi ko nga, whatever your age, whatever your status in life, you try to learn something new. Ano ba yung pwede pang matutunan, di ba? You try to Google kung ano meron. Pwede ba ako magluto ng ganito? Pwede ba, ano bang pwede kong twist sa adobo? Pwede bang magtanim ako ng ganito? So, learn something new. Know your passion. Marami naka-discover niya nung lockdown. Ay, pwede pala ako magluto. Galing ko pala magluto. Nanegosyo pa. Ay, magaling pala ako mag-online selling. Diba? So, yun. Know your passion and cultivate it. Pag alam mo na, cultivate it. And ito, find reasons to celebrate. Diba? Eh, doktora, mahal naman mag-celebrate eh. You don't have to be, ano, you don't have to pay much. You celebrate every moment that we wake up. Diba? You give thanks. You give thanks to the Lord. Yung spirituality natin makukultivate because you celebrate being alive. Diba? You celebrate being with people. Ako, I celebrate today because I am with you today. So kung you find reasons to celebrate, you feel grateful. So lahat ng to mag-i-interplay na yun. You feel grateful. You feel good. You feel confident about. And at the end of the day, masaya tayo. So anong nangyayari pag masaya? De, wala kang stress. Yung anxiety level mo bababa. Papasok ka sa trabaho na nakangiti, maganda yung boss mo, maganda yung outcome ng work mo, marami kang output. So in the end, it's a happy life for you and for the people around you. I think this is my last slide.
Thank you, Doc Belen.
Thank you so much.
Thank you so much.
Ay, nag-extend ako yan.
Thank you so much, Doc, for highlighting, of course, the importance of self-awareness and also giving us an idea on the different types of stressors, both internal and external, different types of stress responses, which I think a lot of us may have identified ourselves into one of the three or all in different occasions.
And of course,
yes, and of course, for giving us tips on how to manage the different types of stress, anxiety, and other mental health issues. Let's take on some questions here from the chat. And I think I'll start with one of the questions that I wanted to also bring up earlier, and related to the question here of Mr. Juan Carlos. You did mention about resilience. And I think a lot of us here in the healthcare workers, we're a very resilient population, especially after going through the pandemic and the urgency and the stress of the response needed. However, is this a tip that you want us, that you suggest for everyone? Do we really need to avoid the stress or be resilient to stress? Or would you suggest that we become more productive or improve our management of stress when we go to the root cause of stress?
Okay. So, I think yung pag-avoid ng stress, yun yung hinighlight din natin na as much as possible, we do not want you to avoid the stress, but rather manage the stress. No? Kasi literally, when you try to avoid, di ba yung ginagawa ng iba, iwas pusoy lang, hindi ko isipin yan. Pero if you do not do anything about it, at the back of your mind, nandun pa rin siya eh. Hindi pa siya mawawala. Hindi pa siya mawawala. So, yun ang, kaya maraming tao nagbe-breakdown eh. Because yung little stresses, in-example ko nga, little stresses na dumadating, kunyari ito, pumatong na siya dito. hindi mo siya pinansin, dinisregard mo, inavoid mo, pero hindi mo binigyan ng solusyon. And there's another stress coming in. There's another one, another one, another one. Pag yung stress level mo, lumampas na sa'yo. Diba? So, dun lalabas yung symptoms. Kasi your body can no longer handle all the stresses. Remember the pressure, the stretch. No? Hindi na siya healthy sa'yo kasi mas mataas na siya sa'yo eh. You just cannot handle. Parang ginagaya ko yun sa bulkan or sa jar. Pag overflowing na, you can only hold as much eh. Kung sobra na siya, mag-spill na siya. At yung spillage, yun yung symptoms na lumalabas. Unang-una, physical symptoms. Kasi most people, ayaw naman nilang makaramdam emotionally eh. They will be very avoidant about it. Kasi nga, as much as possible, ayaw nila, yung awareness thing, ano din eh, parang denial. Kaya nga sabi ko, you do some self-talk eh. Kasi hindi ka naman makakapag-deny sa sarili mo eh. Pero kung hindi ka sanay sa ganon, madi-disregard mo yung emotional component and puro ka denial, lalalim ng lalalim. So pagdating ng time na puro spillage na siya, hindi naman mawawala stress, diba sabi ko, stress will always be part of us.
Correct.
Diba? So yung spillage, habang dumadagdag, edi lumalaki yung spillage, diba? Ngayon, hindi mo na alam, in most of the patients that do breakdown, ang sasabihin lang sa'yo, yung pinaka-tip, tip, kasi po, ano yung break ng mga boyfriend eh. So, akala mo, yun lang. And the patient is suicidal. Diba? Yung pala, parang may kulang sa kwento. So, yung pala, napunta na, dumami na nga siya ng dumami. So, mahirap nang i-identify. So, yun na nga, not to avoid, but to learn to manage. Kasi, yung management mo of stress will take away yung sinasabi ko, hindi na siya magpapatong-patong. Matatanggal na siya.
Okay.
Matatanggal na siya, so hindi na siya mapupuno. Hanggang kaya mo lang.
Okay. That's a good suggestion, Doc. So manage the stress, not avoid it. Kumbaga, we still have to confront these stresses.
Yes.
Hindi natin kailangan aware ka, ha? Kailangan aware. Kasi maraming tao, most often, di ba, sa workplace natin, ha? Di ba, sometimes it's the people around us, uy, parang stress ka ngayon, na, o parang hindi ka nakatulog, o parang maitang ulo mo ngayon, ha? Di ba? Yung tao, ay, talaga, hagardo na ba ako?
Doc, speaking of awareness, we have two questions here from Dr. Z and Ms. Cherry, which is, I think, sila naman ay more concerned citizens. This is more related to people around them, family, yeah, or friends who are in denial. So, would you have a suggestion on how to approach someone who you think would have mental health issues, whether anxiety or depression, given that there's a stigma in mental health? How do we recommend for them to see a professional or to seek counseling?
Okay. So, alam mo, yun nga eh, yung mental health problems, mental health conditions, parang hindi siya saleable. Alam siya, hindi siya mabenta. Kasi nga lahat ng tao, parang avoiding, parang because of the stigma. Unlike kung may lagnat ka, ito, pa-doktor tayo, masakit ang ipin ko, pa-dentist tayo, masakit yung ganito ko, di ba? Pero pag nalulungkot ka, parang di kaya ko pa, di ba? So, the best way for us, kung alam mo, yun nga sabi ko eh, di ba? It's the people around you who notice that there might be something wrong. So, yun lang, honest assessment. Parang pasukin mo lang yung tao in terms of, na hindi threatening. Parang pansin ko lagi ka nag-iisip. O parang pansin ko, parang hindi ka na masyadong masaya ngayon. Diba? So you talk about feelings kaysa yung i-confront mo, may problema ka ba? Diba? Parang, hindi, wala akong problema. Diba? So you try to approach them in a way that makukuha mo yung feelings nila. You talk about how you see them. No, na, ay parang pansin ko parang hindi ka na yata kasing babe ko sa dati. O parang pansin ko parang yung output mo sa work parang hindi na as ano, hindi na kasing bilis or hindi yung pagkuha mo ng aking mga instructions, hindi ka na kasing bilis, hindi na ano. So, yun, is there anything that may be bothering you? Yun.
That's a good ano, recommendation. Uh-huh. Ano, parang approach them in a more on how you know these people, no? Kunwari, kung family member mo sila and you know them better, the approach to them is also very different. Okay.
Alam mo, sa totoong buhay, maraming ganyan eh. Maraming pasyente na ano, maraming pasyente na maraming relatives ang pupunta. Paano mo namin dadalahin? Sabi ko, kasi you know that person better than I do. Diba? Mas alam mo silang i-approach, pero huwag nang takotin. Sige, pag hindi ka nagbago, dadaling kita sa psychiatrist. Alam mo yung gano'n. Parang, magkasalanan ba na ano?
And that also, ano, grows the stigma of mental health, no?
Yeah.
Doc, we have a question here. Does prolonged anxiety or depression lead to more serious health conditions? And I remember you mentioning na nagpa-pile up lang din ang mga stress natin.
Yung kasi nga yung sinasabi ko, spectrum yan eh. Wala naman biglang magbe-breakdown eh. Yung breakdown is the most severe eh. When we say breakdown, usually tantamang to psychotic breakdown. Eh. You lose control of ano of yourself. Kaya marami ka nagagawang bagay na hindi naman dapat. Ang talagang reason for the breakdown is you lose control. Bakit how does a person lose her control? Yun na nga, pag marami nang nagpatong-patong, lahat ng mental health conditions, lahat ng most severe form, doon nag-uumpisa sa basic, which is stress. Kaya sabi ko, I deemed it right to talk about stress. Kasi nga, pag alam mong i-handle yung stress, hindi na siya magpo-progress. Diba? Pag alam mo i-cope yung stress, yung sabi ko kanina, yung nag-pile, ay pwede na matanggal siya. So, lagi na lang siyang manageable level. Pero kung mas madami yung pumapasok kaysa sa lumalabas, doon nagkakaroon ng problem. Kaya, ang pinakaano rin, you learn, yun na sabi ko, do not forget, self-talk pa rin.
Agarido.
Self-talk, kasi yun lang yung ano, honest talk. Kasi hindi ka naman makakapag-deny sa sarili mo eh.
That's right. Okay. Sige, are there any other questions? Meron pa ba tayong questions from our audience?
Okay.
Okay. Doc Belen, thank you very much for your talk, your lecture, and of course for answering all the questions from our audience. I'm sure marami po tayong baon na learnings. At sana po ay hindi na masyadong stress drillon at Hagarda Versosa ang sangkatauhan natin dito sa Qualimed. I agree with you, Doc. Self-awareness is key. And a lot of us may also, as you mentioned, yung mga type A, and of course, tayo mga healthcare workers, talagang push talaga tayo, di ba? Very resilient. A lot of us might not be noticing na we are already or we have reached our capacities. And only when we start experiencing some symptoms do we really seek for help and realize na something is wrong. So, very good reminder for everyone to also keep us in check and keep our family and friends in check as well. And to end, of course, our program for the day, allow me to call, of course, mayroon pala tayong ano, certificate of appreciation first.
Yes.
That we will send to Dr. Belen.
Ayan. So actually, Dr. Beleno, we'd like to thank you very much for gracing this session, our fifth. Actually, talagang we're closing this series with a bang. We have extended our session. We'd like to thank everybody. We're still at 93 attendees. We were at a high of 125 participants. I have no idea yet on our Facebook reach. However, we're very thankful to everyone also for staying. And of course, to Dr. Belen for your time. No? Like sabi ni Dr. Nikki, we learned a lot. And I'm sure meron tayong mga baon na maiuuwi natin sa ating mga pamilya at sana ma-share din natin sa kanila to extend the advice of si Dr. Belen, no? So we can live in managing the stress. So again, from the QualiMed Health Network, we would like to present the Certificate of Appreciation to Dr. Belen M.D. Matatak for her expertise and what valuable role as a speaker during the webinar entitled Hagardo Versosa Battling Work-Related Anxieties, given this fifth day of May 2022 via Zoom virtual event, signed by, actually, she is here, Attorney Nirmala Vanguardia. Hello, Attorney, our OIC Vice President for Human Resources, Ms. Margaret A. Bengzon, our Group Chief Operating Officer, and of course, our President and CEO, Dr. Jaime Ismael. Ayan. So thank you, Dr. Belen. Maraming salamat.
Thank you.
And of course, our next appreciation is to Dr. Nicole B. Bautista for her expertise and valuable role as moderator during the webinar entitled The Most Creative, as you said, Hagardo Versosa, Battling Work-Related Anxieties. Given this fifth day of May 2022 via Zoom, signed by Attorney Nirmala Vanguardia, Ms. Margaret Bengzon, and Mr. Jaime Ismael. Thank you, of course, to Dr. Rizzi for opening this session. Maraming salamat po. And of course, to close this very wonderful event for us and the entire series of QHN. So again, with the help of Dr. Gina, who is also in the call, umabot ka doc, let us all welcome the new medical director of QualiMed Surgery Center Manila, Dr. Mark Paul, or Dr. Angkoy Lopez. Dr. Angkoy?
Hi, good afternoon.
Hello, doc.
Hindi ko kagad mabuksan yung video ko kasi baka ma-judge ako, may makita ko yung physical manifestations ng anxiety.
Hello, Doc. We'll guard the Versosa.
Hindi ko dala yung machete ko eh. Yeah. Thank you again to everyone. Ma'am Bambi, thank you for organizing this. And Dr. Belen, Nikki, thank you. And Rizzi, thank you for opening the session this afternoon. It's a proof that Ateneo and UP can actually work together well outside the basketball court.
No, we mentioned LaSalle also, Doc. Me coming from LaSalle.
No. I'm just talking to you. And of course, LaSalle, of course. Lahat yan, okay. Basta outside the basketball court. Joke lang po. Thank you, Dr. Belen, for enlightening us about mental health concerns, that these are not just stuff that you read on Facebook, on social media, and this is very real, even in the workplace, at home, and we should be taking care of ourselves, and it's okay to prioritize ourselves and be able to manage stress. And I think beyond being able to take care of ourselves as a group in QualiMed, we should be able to take care of each other and make things better for each other. So wag na po nating, hindi ko na po papatagalin, so you can have more of your now moment. And wag na nating dagdagan ng stress natin. Just vote right on Monday and have a good afternoon. Thank you.
Thank you, Dr. Angkoy. Maraming salamat. And can I please just give a little more time? Dr. Ginema, I call on you. Please, let's close this five-topic session of our QHN OSH series. Dr. Gina, can we hear from you, please? Doc Jeans, are you still there? Ayan, asa na si Doc? All right. Ayan, ayaw ma-open daw. Humabol si Doc, galing yan ang isa pang meeting. Oh, anyway, ayaw talaga ma-open, Doc. It's okay. So again, thank you very much again, guys. This five series session, this series of QHN is actually will be downloaded in our YouTube channel, the QHN.tv. So we can all access that. So for those other sessions that you missed, and if you want to repeat this session with Dr. Belen, you can access it through our YouTube channel, which is QHN.tv. So moving forward, guys, we hope you learned a lot with this sessions, our series for our OSH web series. And hopefully, we can hear from you kung ano pa yung pwede nating mabigay sa inyo moving forward so we can further develop each other, no, through the support also of our partner doctors. So again, maraming salamat. Please let us all vote wisely on Monday, and please let's all be safe.
Ayan, Bambi, na-open na.
Ayan ka na, asan ka na?
Ayan, na-open na.
Oh, parang I cannot end the 5-day session.
Thank you, everyone. Thank you, everyone, for staying with us for the past, ilang sessions ba yun?
5 po, Doc.
Oh, 5 sessions. Tapos let us know kung ano pa, ha? Kung ano pang gusto ninyong topics. Oo, kung gusto nyo i-extend natin yung kay Dr. Di Matatak. Kasi mukhang interesado mga tao eh. Doktora, wag madadala.
Ay, gusto ko yan.
Thank you very much.
Alright, so again, thank you very much, guys. Team QualiMed, friends of QualiMed, maraming salamat. Have a safe trip home. May pasok pa bukas. Monday pa po. Kala ko Friday na eh.
Pili ko din Friday eh.
Ako din. Bye, guys. Thank you very much. Thank you, Day. Thank you, everyone. Maraming salamat. Thanks, Doc Gina. Doc Angkoy, thank you.
Thank you, everybody. Salamat.
Salamat. Bye-bye.
Go Team QualiMed Manila. Bye, everyone.